followed by the channel encoder. Followed by the modulator. Sorry. Channel encoder. Okay, that's modulator. And we have the channel. So it can be a wired channel or wireless channel. And at the receiving side, the first component is your channel decoder. And the second component is the analog to digital converter or digital to, digital to analog converter. And the last one is your destination. So as I said, we need a discrete information source. The output of the discrete information source are the sequence of symbols. So that you can represent with some BK, so which is a sequence of symbols, or you can represent with any other notation also. Now this sequence of symbols will be given as an input for the source encoder. So source encoder is a device which takes the sequence of symbols as an input and it will convert these symbols into binary bits. So the output of the source encoder is the binary data. So we can say the output is either 0 or 1. Okay. So there are number of source encoders. The examples for the source encoders are Shannon Fan, which is available on our syllabus, Hoffman, and there are number of source encoders. Okay. So now this binary data will be given as an input for the channel encoder. So the purpose of the channel encoder is, so basically the channel encoder will add some extra bits to this binary data and it will convert into some other data. Again, it's a binary data, but it contains your original binary data plus some extra bits. So the extra bits which we are adding to the original binary data is known as the parity bits. So with the help of these parity bits at the receiving side, so we will be able to find out the errors, and if possible we can correct the errors also. So the basic purpose of this